the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everybody. You are all very welcome as we come together here to celebrate this Mass in the shadow of the chapel. On behalf of Father Brian and myself, we are here and gladly celebrate this Mass because we remind ourselves of over 200 years ago when the Mass was celebrated here in the castle itself. It was a safe place to celebrate Mass at the time, and I suppose in comparison with some of the Mass rocks around the country, it was a bit more sheltered. Today, we're grateful to have the fine day for this celebration. So, as we come to celebrate today, we come to give thanks for all of those people who attended Mass for many years in the castle. We pray that they are with the Lord celebrating today too. So we begin our celebration then by asking the Lord for healing and forgiveness for all our sins of fear. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law, open upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Amos. Listen to this, you who trample on the needy and try to suppress the poor people of the country. You who say, when will new moon be over so that we can sell our corn and save it, so that we can market our wheat? Then by lowering the bushel, raising the shekel, by swindling and tampering with the scales, we can buy up the poor for money and the needy for a pair of sandals, and get a price even for the sweepings of the wheat. The Lord swears it by the pride of Jacob. Never will I forget a single thing you have done. The word of the Lord.
Letter of St. Paul to Timothy. My advice is that first of all there should be prayers offered for everyone, petitions, intercessions, and thanksgiving, and especially for kings and others in authority, so that we may be able to live religious and reverent lives in peace and quiet. To do this right and will please God and Saviour. He wants everyone to be saved and reach full knowledge of the truth. For there is only one God, and there is only one mediator between God and mankind, himself a man, Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for a ransom for them all. He is the evidence of this, sent at the appointed time, and I have been named a herald and apostle of it, and I am telling the truth and no lie. A teacher of the faith and the truth to the pagans. In every place, then, I want the men to lift their hands up reverently in prayer with no anger or argument. The word of the Lord.
Held on to their faith.
us some reminders of those past times. Today, we have a chalice here. It's called the Randall Oak Holly Chalice. And the date on it is 1633. So it's almost 400 years old. That chalice, no doubt, was used here for the celebration of Mass. So we're grateful that we have the chalice here today with us for this Mass. 200 years ago, in 1819, Father Daughney, who had been appointed parish priest of Dunmanway in May 1818, he secured the land for the church here, which he started to build. It was the first of three churches that he built here in the parish over a time of 15 years. No doubt, the difficulties that he faced in trying to pay for them were great too. But he seemed to be able to use his diplomatic skills to even get support from non-members of the church. And as we read in Father Donald Donovan's book, he went to great lengths to make sure that the people had a place, a worldly place to worship. So we're grateful that we're now celebrating the bicentenary of the church here in Ballinacarriga. We have here in front, you'll be able to look at it more closely later, what was probably an altar stone, blessed by the then Bishop of Cork, Bishop Murphy, his name is on it, in 1819. So that was the beginning of the building of the church. It was opened, we believe, in the year 1820, or could even have been 21. But so today we're here to give thanks for the people who went before us, for their great faith and support, and we're here to ask the Lord to not just to look at the past and be grateful for it, but the present as well. To ask ourselves how we can do our part at this time to make sure that we continue to celebrate in the years to come. We have here the future of the church. We have a beautiful group of children here, and they will be the ones to bring and continue that faith for the future. So we are praying for you especially today, and we thank you for being here with us and your teachers looking after you, and they are the ones who will be preparing you for that future. So while we give thanks for the past, we pray that we, at the present, will have the strength and courage to continue that faith and practice. And we pray that you, in the future, will continue that as well. So it's appropriate now that we stand and profess that faith as we pray together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell on the third day. He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Now we have the prayers of the faithful. And we ask the Lord to listen to these and all our prayers to grant.
We pray for the volunteers who work tirelessly to maintain this beautiful historical village. May it always be a haven of peace and tranquility for all who visit. We pray for all volunteers in the wider community. Your contribution keeps small rural communities alive and fosters a special bond for all who live and work here. Lord, hear us.
For the church, that in her ministry of evangelization she may preach the need for social justice and respect. For the most vulnerable, Lord, hear us.
May our parish, community, and our neighborhoods be places of kindness, where we esteem each other and show courtesy and compassion in our speaking and acting. Lord, hear us.
We pray for our church sacristans, our ministers of the word, ministers of the Eucharist, collectors, and all who give so generously of their time to the church. Lord, hear us.
We pray for our school community in Ballinacarriga, staff, children, and parents. Ballinacarriga School is the nucleus of our community and the indispensable part of it. We thank the teachers, both past and present, who help to hand on the faith to the generations of children. Lord, hear us.
We pray for our priests, Father Collins, who has been so much part of this wonderful occasion and has supported and encouraged us every step of the way. And Father Evan, who is a caring and friendly presence in our community. Lord, hear us.
Today marks a very special occasion. 200 years ago and beyond, people came to celebrate Mass here at Ballinacarriga Castle. We think of the generations of people who continue to practice their faith here, often of very difficult conditions. Lord, hear us.
We ask the Lord to listen to these and all our prayers. We pray especially today for all the deceased members of the Horley clan, in particular for Barra O'Mirna and all the associated with this castle here. Lord, hear us. And together now we pray and ask Mary to intercede for us as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. We ask your Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for the everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, and in joyful celebration, we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, about all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks, said the blessing, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim in song the mystery of our faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Clinton, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Nimish Conadahir, Tamar of Owen, or Slot of Or Doing, Ian. Or Nahir, or Nav, Ray of the Cannon, Rudolph of the Ray, Priest of the Holland and Dollar, or Yet for Nav. All Ron Lay Hool, who do we know, the Sago in our theatre, or Bohemi Dabbe, who the same, the Sadiq Synagogue, or Searching Wall. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, for every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope of the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, by peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other and wish one another that peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
life, all praise and all thanksgiving every moment I. I am the bread of life, says the Lord. You who eat this bread will live forever. The bread that I shall give is my flesh for the life of the world. O sacred, O holy, O sacred divine, all praise and all thanksgiving every moment time. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our lives, through Christ our Lord. Now, before the final blessing, I'd like to say a word of thanks to a lot of people who have put in a lot of preparation, as you can see all around here. Great work that was done over the past number of weeks, even months, to prepare the place for this Mass. To thank, I won't thank people individually, but thank people in general, for the great organization that you've put into this. And we're delighted to see such a large crowd here today to celebrate this important occasion. This is only the beginning of the celebration. People who know Ballinacarriga would realize that they like to celebrate, not just once or twice, but over many times. So in the coming year especially, we will have a number of significant celebrations. As I mentioned, the chalice here, which we have for the Mass, is a very special one, going back nearly 400 years. What we hope is that perhaps down in the hall, where there will be refreshments afterwards, this of course is Gabriel will allow it to see the chalice up close, because she's in charge of it, so she managed in her diplomacy to get it from the diocese, from the cathedral, where it is safely guarded, and we have just for a few days. But I'm sure we'll get it again for other celebrations. As well as that, as I mentioned there, the altar stone here in front, you're quite free to come to look at that. That is precious, but it is important and significant as well. So I'd like to thank you all, especially our choir and the school choir, for this celebration here today. And I hope you enjoy it very much. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you all and be with you always. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, to love, and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
There's an old castle ruined by the village, with its walls reaching up to the sky. Overlooking the calm, placid waters of the beautiful lake just close by. How often in youth there I rambled and climbed in stone stairs to the top, for to see on the water, till my eyes said to that village with its bar, school, and chapel, and the rock where the old castle stands. I dream of the friends that I knew long ago, as they danced on that high storied green, each lad with a smile that would surely beguile the heart of his Irish colleague. And I mean